The Smoother by Phil Spicer is a plugin that a lot of you have requested me to take a look at. And I haven't even started and I'm already frustrated. So let's talk about that. So, The Smoother. Smooth. Perfect. Whatever. This is the plugin. It's from Phil Spicer. What I always like to do is get the trial version of a plugin. Sometimes I get like the license from the maker of the plugin. Oftentimes I'm using a trial. That's not possible. I asked this actually at the Phil AI and they say, no, I do not offer a demo or trial versions of my plugins. However, I do provide a 30-day full refund policy, allowing you to purchase and try my product with assurance that you can receive full refund if it doesn't meet your needs within the first 30 days. I think it's fair enough to be able to receive a refund, but every other plugin company is doing this. Like literally 95% of the business, you can just get the plugin for free for 30 days and then it locks up, makes weird noises, whatever. And this creates a certain threshold for people to try it out. And that way you have to trust me and other reviewers even more. And of course there's a 30-day refund, so it's not that bad, but it's a little frustrated. So I went ahead and I bought this plugin and I'm not going to return it. I don't think that's right because I am going to use it for this video, of course. But yeah. So what is this plugin? It's audio smoothing, but reimagined, because that's the thing that we are doing in the plugin business. We're reimagining every single thing. We're constantly developing new stuff. Actually, we're putting old stuff in a new jacket, but you know, that's something that the plugin industry doesn't want you to know. Every music producer should have a resonance fixer in their arsenal, but the high quality ones are super expensive. I decided to stop the gatekeeping. And that's actually good because I paid, what did I pay for this thing actually? I paid 20 euros for it. So, you know, that's a lot better than Soothe that costs 200 euros. It's like 1/10 of it. So that's good, that's good. The Smoother tackles harsh resonances, muddy lows and sibilant highs with surgical precision. It's like having an EQ with hundreds of bands that intelligently work for you, packed with my innovative take, 4-band control for super intuitive and quick workflow. Yeah, that's not on the other ones. The other ones have different ways of controlling. The Smoother was ready only after beating every competitor in my rigorous tests, regardless of their price. Okay, but what is so unique about this then? Like, tell us a little bit more. Where can we hear the difference? What you know, how can we test this claim? I'm actually working on like reviews of products where manufacturers are literally showing what the difference is. They're showing graphs and everything where you can verify things yourself and stuff. Like, you know, I was able to make records that amassed to hundreds of millions of streams using my sounds and tools. You can do it too. I think a lot of people can do it, but getting hundreds of millions of streams, I wouldn't sell it that way. I would just more focus on the quality, which is weird coming from someone that just completely effed up a sponsorship. But hey, all right, there's a guarantee as well. It's ensured that every user of my products has an absolute blast using them. This is what motivates me to push the boundaries of music software. Okay. Yeah, I don't know what is pushing the boundaries of this yet. I don't know. There's a lot of air here. The only boundary that he's pushing is the price. Rare case that something doesn't work as expected. I'm committed to making it work for you. Okay. We'll believe that guarantee. Maybe I should try that out. Maybe not. So yeah, this is the plugin. And one of the things I already noticed is let's enable oversampling, by the way, on both. Yeah. Oh, that's actually it. Oh, that's interesting. Okay. Okay, yeah. So if your computer is not powerful enough, then you can turn it off. But when rendering, it turns itself on again. Okay, so one of the things I noticed, which is a user interface thing, is this here. You have to click on a band and then you can control it. Why, you know, there's room enough down here. Why not have two dials here for every band? Then you can immediately access them. Just a thought. Anyway. Oh, that's already doing a lot. Mid only. You can also do sides only. Come on. I want to hear it. Interesting, interesting. Mm-hmm.
doing a lot over here. Let's reduce the sensitivity. Would be nice to have some visual feedback as well of what we're doing here. I think this sensitivity is more like the threshold, reduction is more like the ratio. When So when I'm at 0%, it's still doing something there. And here. Oh, now. Okay. Okay. Oh, there's. I don't think there's enough to reduce and the low frequencies actually. Oh, there we go. Okay. So we don't have enough low frequency stuff. Oh, there we go. And actually, I like what it is doing here. Like, actually doing this makes the track sound a little bit more open. Because the bass is quite dominant. What do we have here? Oh, that's a filter. Okay, yeah, so that we can not process that part. Okay, yeah. And well, that's it, I think. Is that it? Okay, so we have some presets in here. Simple, smooth. I would, you know, you can start with a preset, but always fine tune. D-mud, that's something that we need on this track, D-mud. Let's bypass. It's doing that very nice. I mean, you know. Super smooth. It's not bad. It's not bad. No spray. Definitely something that I need. Okay. If it works, it works. I think it's a very simple plugin, which can be beneficial for a lot of people as well. Like, don't make it too difficult. I have no problems with gaining or weird stuff going on. It actually fixes exactly what needs to be fixed in the track. And it's also quite affordable, like 20 euros for this plugin. So I'm not going to like snake oil this because of that. However, the simplicity is sometimes a little bit too much for me, but maybe I just like to overcomplicate certain things. So yeah, that's what I think of the Phil Spicer, the smoother. I'm going to link to Phil Spicer in the description down below. So you can check out the plugin yourself. You have to buy it in order to check it out. But according to Phil, you're getting your money back. If that doesn't happen, leave a comment down below. I'll make a follow-up video completely burning the whole company. Because, you know, if you guarantee giving the money back, then you gotta come through with it. So if you don't like it, make sure to request a refund with Phil Spicer as well. Now, if you like my videos and want to support me, consider using my affiliate links. They're in the description down below or over here. And when using my affiliate link, a little bit of your purchase gets kicked back to me. So you can purchase whatever you want. You're not paying anything extra, but you are supporting the channel and it helps a lot. Another way to support me is by becoming a channel member. You can become a channel member for 99 cents and you're just supporting the channel and you're getting a little star behind your username when commenting. So everybody can see that you are at least supporting. There are also other tiers, early access and exclusive content. I'll link the exclusive content over here and I should get to work soon on the exclusive content, I know. Last way to support me and the whole YouTube platform is by watching more videos. So link an interesting video over here. Thanks a lot for watching, keep pushing and bye bye. Yeah.